Hi folks, this is Checkpoint Quiz 10.5. In number one, we're asked to graph one cycle of a cosine curve. So one way to proceed is to think back to the original cosine curve and realize it had quarter marks, the standard quarter marks over the interval 0 to pi of 0, pi over 2, pi, and 3 pi over 2. And at these quarter marks are where we had the zeros and the local maxes and mins. So the strategy is we're going to set the argument of the cosine function, in other words, what's inside the cosine function, equal to each of these points, and find out what the new x's are for the translated curve. So I set x minus pi over 2 equal to each of these 5 points. 0, pi over 2, pi, 3 pi over 2, and 2 pi. To solve each of these 5 equations, I'm going to do the same 2 operations. I'll first multiply the old x values by 2, and then I'll add pi. So thinking from a transformation point of view, that would be doing a horizontal expansion followed by a shift to the right, pi units. So solving for x here gives x equals pi. Solving for x here gives x equals 2 pi. Here we get x equals 3 pi, x equals 4 pi, and x equals 5 pi. The next step is to find the new y's. And the way we do that is we take each of these x's and plug it into our equation. So for x equals pi, I get y equals 3 minus the cosine of pi minus pi over 2. And if we've done our arithmetic correctly, the argument of the cosine function should always simplify to one of these original 5 quarter marks. So in this case, I get 3 minus the cosine of 0, which is 2. For x equals 2 pi, I get y equals 3 minus cosine 2 pi minus pi over 2, which is 3 minus the cosine of pi over 2. The cosine of pi over 2 is 0, so 3 minus it is 3. For x equals 3 pi, I get y equals 3 minus the cosine of 3 pi minus pi over 2. Which is 3 minus the cosine of 2 pi over 2, or pi. The cosine of pi is negative 1, so 3 minus that is 4. For x equals 4 pi, I get y equals 3 minus cosine of 4 minus pi, 4 pi minus pi over 2, which would be 3 minus the cosine of 3 pi over 2. The cosine of 3 pi over 2 is 0, so that gives me 3. And for x equal 5 pi, I get 3 minus the cosine of 5 pi minus pi over 2. That's 3 minus the cosine of 2 pi. Cosine of 2 pi is 1, so 3 minus 1 is 2. So if you notice, as you go through here, there's a built-in double check that the argument of the cosine works out to be the original 5 quarter marks. Okay, now that I've got the new x's paired with the new y's, I'm all set to go off and graph. Okay, so now we have got the new x's and the new y's that go with them. So we'll check it out here. We now have the quarter mark starting at pi, then 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi, and 5 pi. And when we plugged pi in, we got out 2. We plugged in 2 pi, we got out 3. We plugged in 3 pi, we got out 4. And then 4 pi, we got 3 again. And then 5 pi, we got 2 again. And so then I connect this up in the typical cosine fashion. It's a little rough there. But that's what I can do here on the tablet. So that'd be one cycle of this cosine curve. Now to find all these informations, phase shift, period, and amplitude, I can read that off from the graph. Phase shift, remember, is where the curve starts now. So instead of starting at 0, our first quarter mark here is at pi. So the phase shift is pi, and since it's positive, this is to the right. For the period is how long it takes for the cycle to repeat itself, or how long it takes to graph one cycle. And I can determine that by looking at the length of this interval. I can get the length of the interval by subtracting the right endpoint minus the left endpoint. So the period here is 4 pi. And last but not least, the amplitude is how much the curve oscillates away from the baseline. So the baseline here, the baseline for the cosine function, is always between, it's the average, I should say, of the high point and the low point. So the high point was 4, the low point was 2. If you average 4 and 2, that gives you the baseline 3. And so if I look and see how far this curve meanders from y equals 3, it goes up 1 and down 1. So that means the amplitude is 1. So that's one way to graph this curve. Another way to graph this curve is to determine these three characteristics up front along with the vertical shift and then graph it that way. And that's what we're going to do next.